actually it's not a YA, an adult fiction book review for you today. I have Sunshine here with me. She's being very playful. She's been very good and calm all morning, but as soon as I sat down to film, she jumped, so I'll probably place that part of the video at the end. If you're new here, my name is Jen. This is an introverted lifestyle channel, so I have book reviews, beauty hauls, Dollar Tree hauls, TJ Maxx, Marshalls, Home Goods, and things like that, crafting videos. So if those are things that you like too, then I hope you'll stick around and hit that subscribe button. I might start posting more sporadically, and if you want to be notified, make sure you hit the bell. So the book I have for you is actually a library book, so I don't have it with me at the moment, but it's called The Girl in His Shadow by Audrey Blake. And Audrey Blake is not an actual person. It was written by two women, and that's the name that they write under together, and that was their first book together as well. I decided to do a review about it even though I already returned it, because it was a really good book. It was a little slower-ish, medium-paced, but basically it follows the story of Nora, who survived a pandemic, like a cholera or something. I don't recall offhand which one. And she gets found by a doctor, and he raises her because her entire family dies. And that's kind of just like a quick little bit, like at the beginning. I think it's the prologue. I don't even think it's chapter one. And essentially what ends up happening is Nora learns a lot underneath this doctor, but it's 1840, and it's in, they're not in the States. I don't know if they're in London or if they're around London, but it's not acceptable for women to practice medicine at that time. So then unexpectedly, the doctor takes on like a student named Daniel, and Daniel is like, he doesn't quite know Nora's role and that she helps as much as she does, because the doctor teaches at the university, but he also has like an in-house clinic. And finally Daniel does realize how much Nora knows, and he's kind of taken aback because he comes from like a higher society where he's used to women, you know, kind of being frivolous and, in my opinion, silly, and doing ladylike things and all of that. So he's kind of shocked by Nora, but then like intrigued by her brilliance as well. There's some villainy in terms of this like opposing doctor at the university who challenges everything of Dr. Croft, who Nora works with, and then kind of shit hits the fan, and you know, everything is come into question and she's thrown into the spotlight. There's a little bit about the discovery of ether as an anesthesia. It's not based in fact, like this Nora did not like discover this or anything, but the authors have some author notes about that in the back, about it. And essentially like it was a party drug, like kind of like laughing gas, and then they realized like the medical implications of it, you know, through other people experimenting with it. So it's a really good book. If you like historical fiction, you'll probably like this. There's really no mystery elements to it. It does go pretty deep into technical medical things, especially given the time period and how primitive some procedures were, especially prior to anesthesia being discovered and used widely. The authors had a note in their author note about delving deep into like medical journals from that time. So there's some like OBGYN stuff that's pretty explicit, like right at the beginning. And then there's some deeper dives into some medical terminology and medical procedures. So if you don't like that, you probably want to stay clear, because it's kind of gory. But really the character development is really interesting. I like the love story. For a while there's a little bit of a love triangle. I don't really like the enemies to lover trope, and I wouldn't necessarily say Daniel and Nora were enemies, but if I had to label it with a trope, that's the one that I would use. This book for me fell in between like 3.5 and 4 stars, because it was slower paced and it was kind of dense, but it was also enjoyable to read overall. So if you're kind of looking for something that's a little slower paced, that goes a little bit deeper, and that is historical fiction, maybe with some medical terminology, then this would be a good fit for you. This book just came out in August. I was working at the library and saw it on our new cart. I think I'm the one who like scanned it in at the time. So it is a new release. It just came out. And like I said, it's by Audrey Blake, which is actually two women writing under one pseudonym. Overall, I really enjoyed it. There's going to be a picture of the cover in the thumbnail for this video. Like I said, it was a library book, so I already returned it. But it took me a while to read it. It took me not all summer. Like, I don't think it came out in August. So if I already said that, it came out this summer. I think it came out in like July. It took me like over a month to read it. It might have taken me two. But it's a relatively new book. So if you like historical fiction, and or if you like medical books or books about medical procedures and discoveries, then you probably like this book. If you like the Victorian era and you're also into that kind of stuff, you may enjoy this as well. I would say the medical stuff is more intense at the front, and I think it's kind of to lay the groundwork for Nora's knowledge and to establish her background a little bit. And then more like the love interest, being a woman, practicing medicine when it's against the law, the discovery of ether, I'm pretty sure it's ether, and all that kind of stuff is kind of like the bulk of the middle and end. So the medical, intense, really deep diving medical stuff is kind of more in the front loaded, into the front of the story. So, but anyway, at this point I'm kind of rambling. Hopefully you enjoy the clip of Sunshine, and that's all I have for you. I'll have another book review relatively soon. I'm kind of tearing through this book called Shadow Heart, which is a Phantom of the Opera retelling. That's YA, and it's really, really good. I read like nearly 200 pages in 2 days. So I'm kind of chugging along with that. So I'll probably have a book review for that up soon as well. And I have on the floor right here all the stuff for my Beauty Faves video. So I'll be recording that later today as well. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and stay introverted. Bye! Hey friends, Jen here with a book review for you. This is Sunshine, my newly adopted baby. I've had her about a month. Hi. Yeah. And do a book review video with mommy. What? You wanna come up here? You can come up here. No, don't eat my hair. Don't eat my hair. Whoa. What? Oh. What's the matter? What are you doing?